Bind objects are the standard way to read real-time data from the project. They're supported directly by Graphics Editor, the TGML engine updates them automatically, and our tooling is built around bindings. However, they aren't the only method. Ultimately, the WebHMI is using JavaScript calls back to the server to read data, and we can take advantage of that. Let's get familiar with one new method provided with the software, getDataPoints. To demonstrate, I'm going to create an object that can read any item that I request. As always, I'll start with a text object. But this time, I won't attach a bind, only a script. This will be triggered on mouse click. I'll start by prompting for the item name to read. You've already seen some pop-up windows, like the control components, but I'm going to read my item using a simple window.prompt for now. This is a standard web API that displays a message, enter a point to read, and optionally a default value. I'll use the same point we've been looking at, the utility incomer's A phase current. Now for the new WebHMI function. GetDataPoints takes a list of items or other special values like alarm filters and requests them from the server. I only have one point for now, so I'll pack it in a list and pass it to the function. To receive the value, the WebHMI stores the server's response in a global object called session storage that we'll see again in the future. To retrieve it, I'll call sessionStorage.getItem and pass it the string DataPointVal. This is the key in the session storage object where my variable is stored. Note that I said getDataPoints takes a list of items. If I pass more than one item, DataPointVal will be a comma-separated string of my return values in order. For now, I only passed the one item, so what we have is fine. Finally, I'll jump to the event's current target, that is the text object, and set its content to the stored value. Now that my script is complete, I'll actually need to go to the WebHMI. We've seen that the Preview tab can't read real values from the system. Moreover, the Window, GetDataPoints, and Session Storage objects only exist in the browser. clicking on the text object pops up a message with my prompt and the default item I entered. Remember that this pop-up's appearance will be different depending on the browser, so if consistency is critical, you may want to create your own pop-up, as we'll investigate later. For now, I'll click OK, and my value is populated in the field. If I change to another current, its value is set. This is just a one-time read, though. The value will not update automatically with the server. For that, I would need a loop in the background to periodically refresh the value. This is the most basic method for reading a value from the server without a bind object, but I hope you see its importance. I could have a script load on page load, a loop over a list of values, and effectively replace the binding engine. I could select from multiple devices and have them be read on demand. We'll be using this again in more advanced videos. Until then, thank you.